First of all, I would like to thank the chairs who have given me the opportunity to present the results of my research entitled UFV Detection Using Web Application Approach Based on SSD Pre-trained Model. Prior to that, this research paper was made by me, Leonard Mateo Sostupanata, with my supervisor, Mr. Rinaldi Munir from ITB. First, we will come to the introduction. We know that the use of UFVs is intended to fulfill increasingly complex human need. Also, the UFV is essential in a variety of situations that cannot be done in a human job. UFV technology integrates autonomous capabilities with aerial vehicles to do a variety of tasks. Drone chasing competitions is one of the competition to compete to take each other. More difficult problems for autonomous drones to solve, and this UAV must learn about the location of other drones by detection. To do the detection, we use TensorFlow Object Detection API. This is the most widely used API for detecting object captured on camera. Next, we will talk about SSD. This object detection method, which is good for detecting small targets because low-level feature maps is used with high resolution process. The previous research on mobile net and ResNet models is McEwen et al. Have proposed the real-time detection of flying drones by prioritizing the concept of a lightweight model with good accuracy. But the accuracy of this model is still lacking and requires heavy computing on the onboard processing. We note that the onboard processing will be used a lot of memory and longer computational time. Fadi et al. Have proposed the efficient way for real-time UFV object detection, but unfortunately, as we can see in the picture, the proposed method does not detect other UFV in more detail, so they cannot be used for tracking other UFV. The purpose of this research is that a new web application approach will be proposed, and the precision obtained is expected to be greater than 80%, and the successful recall number obtained is expected to be greater than 70%. Pre-trained model also will be developed with the help of cloud computing and can be stored in a separate storage to make a computational time shorter. This will be enabled to be accessed asynchronously from internet access, so the computing process will be speed up. Now, we will come to the proposed method. This is the workflow for model training initiation. So the data will be gathering and will be labeled by UAV on non-UAV label class and will be prepare notebook for training with TensorFlow Object Detection API and will be create TF record for training. This is the ground truth data. So the data will be know which is UAV on not. Then we will be do hyperparameter tuning for get the best parameter, and then we will do training and evaluation, converting checkpoints to create a new graph, and will be convert to the graph that supports TensorFlow.js, and we will be insert the graph for the in the code storage bucket. This is the proposed web application architecture from user. We will be triggered on click to choose the model and show detection result with bounding box from the object detection web. And then with the help of TensorFlow Object Detection API, we'll be extracted image and send bounding box position to be drawn. The last, we will be use the graph model in cloud bucket storage to request graph model from the cloud. The data set that we use is 12,000 image such as 6,000 positive image for the UAV of the fixed wing and the 6,000 negative image for kite, bird, etc. As we can see in the picture, there are positive data sets and negative data sets, which is the proportion of test data set is 2%, dev data set is also 2%, and the trained data set is 96%. In the pre-trained model, there are a lot of method or pre-trained model that we use in there. This is SSD Mobile Net, ResNet 50, and ResNet 101. We choose the SSD Mobile Net V2, V3, T1FPN640 because the speedest model and then the COCO MIP, we will find the best model to be trained. For the hyperparameter tuning, we do the random search to search the batch size, warm-up step, and warm-up rate. And for its model, we find that for mobile net, the batch size is 12, and optimal warm-up step is 5,000, and the warm-up rate is 0.013. Okay, so the result and analysis, we get the loss value used for get the difference between training picture and the ground truth that we set in the TF graph record. And we know that mobile net V2 has the lowest loss, which is 0.09, but the ResNet 101 is the highest loss value with 0.142. For the formula of the precision is TP division with TP plus FP. TP stands for true positive, while FP stands for false positive. From the precision graph, we can see for the mobile net V2 has the highest value of precision with the scale of 0.885, while the ResNet 101 has the lowest precision value with scale 0.856. Now we will see the recall value, and for recall, the formula is TP division with TP plus FN. TP stands for true positive, while FN stands for false negative. And we will see in the recall graph, the mobile net V2 also has the highest recall value with scale of 0.923, while ResNet 101 also has lowest value of recall with only 0.9. Now we will see the web interface of UAV object detection using new model. The user can choose the current model to use SSD Mobile Net V2 or SSD ResNet. And for the runtime model measurement, we use two types of measurement such as load model time and average detection time. Load model time is measured from the initiating model from the code storage bucket to the user computers in the local storage, while average detection time is measured from the previous frame to use detection to the next frame to use the detection. And the mobile net V2 has the lowest measurement time with the scale of 12.27 seconds, while the average detection time of mobile net V2 also has the lowest measurement time with only 1.5 seconds. And the ResNet 101 has the highest value of load model time and the average detection time, such as 209.21 for load model time and 25.9 for average detection time. Finally, we come to conclusion and future works. For the conclusion, a new web application approach has been generated to obtain an optimal object detection model. New pre-trained SSD MobileNet V2 FPN precision value is 0.85 and recall value or sensitivity value is 0.837. The processing runtime of the web application is lower than the onboard processing of the UAV because the onboard processing of the UAV just use the local memory, so the computational runtime is slower than before. And then for the future works, we will improve the runtime by exploring another web architecture, pre-trained models, and method. The model will be developed to be integrated with ground control stations of the UAV, allows the detection and classification of other flying objects, and then we can transmit object detection result to multiple computers and device in the real time. Finally, we can use the model to measure the UAV speed and anti-theft detection. This is the reference that we use for do the research. And that's all for me. Thanks very much.